I won't start with cha 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 Igbo mamanu. But if you check your calendar, you go see, say today na May 6th, and today na the start of the holy month of Ramadan. So based on say I dey like balance everything, instead of make I talk say cha 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 Igbo mamanu, based on my dressing, I go say Ramadan Karim to all the Muslim faithfuls inside Obodo Nigeria and the world. Make una remember the holy month of Ramadan. Now for time, make we sit down, think about our life. Think, say, as human being, you be ordinary sansan. And by the time when you go, the good things when you do for this life, naive people go they remember. So the fact say you not chop some kind food for a particular period, now today remember your body, say, hey, you be ordinary human being. And at the end of the holy month, everybody go talk, say, make we thank God. Now, we don't see better messages from our president, the Senate president, different governors, people, they wish our Muslim brothers and sisters well. And then they talk, say, make people imbibe the true values of the holy month of Ramadan, where you go behave yourself. And when they talk, say, make it not just be said that the holy month of Ramadan, say, it go be all year round. When I don't hear that particular one, those of us will be Christians. We dey wait, make we finish. Because now this particular one, then they go kira. My Muslim friends, we know they quarrel. Just buy the ram, keep. And I know say, you get the kind of granite oil when I the lime, when I use fry that ram. Because now after 2 weeks, I'm going to chop my own. No need to talk too much. Who could be still a special assignment when they settle quarrel between NLC and Nigerian governors as it is concerned this 30,000 naira minimum wage. But I get Ogbonge visitor when we say, every time when he come to discuss matter of Nigeria, the team must always come out smoke. In name, na engineer Nnamdi Ikechukwu. Welcome to Aside Hot.
Thank you.
I like the fact. My name is Chukwu Dio. For here.
Yes.
But that other one, now outside. I like the fact, say, as a young person, issue when we say consign everybody inside of Nigeria, the thing they touch you for body and you they like Chukwu Mount on top. Yeah. I like the fact say we start with the introduction about the holy month of Ramadan. What we go do now to just go small break. When we go this break, come back, we go launch, enter inside our stories. I won't let everybody when they house now, when they watch, you know, say the stories won't go do today. Today, I'm gonna talk about for the third time. Today, be like saying now like final battle on top of us in the heart. No go anywhere when they come back. Now still as in the heart. Welcome back to Aside Hot. Hezugu Chukwudi, as usual, every weekday from 6:30 go to 7:30 day inside studio. And I don't tell you now, say Unkubi go special assignment. When I know say, since we don't talk about that 30,000 naira minimum wage, we don't talk, say we go need person when we say, as NLC, they carry fire come. Nigerian governors, them, only God know the kind. But you go there, they are set at the tent and say, everybody must keep to agreement because agreement is agreement. Unkubi now they do that work. But we get Ogbonge visitor when we say, any matter will concern Obodo Nigeria, in the like carry the matter for head. Now, why we don't invite her and come say, oh yeah, yourself, come talk your mind as it take concern the matter what we discuss. Now, you go good, make I talk and make everybody know. On top of as it hurts, not be to just discuss the problem of Nigeria. We then discuss the problem, believing, say, everybody inside Nigeria consider themselves as important people inside everything what they do to make Nigeria better. And in our own little way, as we talk this problem, we they think of solution, and we they work to see, say, our country better. Once again, engineer Nnamdi Ikechukwu inside studio. Welcome to Aside Hot again.
Thank you, Chukwudi.
Make we no waste time, we could just go straight into our discussion. Our first story get to do with security inside Obodo, Nigeria. And President Muhammadu Buhari yesterday, after the private visit, when he carry go inside the United Kingdom, he don't come back to Obodo, Nigeria. And they come back, when he come back to hear news for inside our great country, Nigeria. And this news now, how survivors, people when we say badness of banditry, onto these bad people, when they carry gun, they kill people, they burn village, they carry people property, they kidnap people, the kind of badness when we say that they do for different parts of this country, especially for inside Zamfara State and also Katsina State. Many of them don't come out now, they use their own mouth. They talk the way when we say they take survive. The kind of things when we say they take do. It just they very clear, say, for matter when concern insecurity inside Obodo Nigeria, it don't reach the level where we say we need to do something when they're very, very important. But everybody gets their definition of how the matter they and waiting they think of the matter and how they think of the solution. You got one video now when we go play, give una make everybody see. It got to do with the question when we say new story person ask President Muhammadu Buhari about this insecurity matter, and when they catch a one-on-one from the time when we say he don't greet our service chiefs them and security people, come carry waka meet new story people. And I go like make una use una ear hear that question and also hear in answer before I come break down the discussion, and we go come talk the matter, enter inside the issue. Make una watch and hear waiting in talk to the question. I take the thing slowly so that everybody go hear them again. The new story person asked President Muhammadu Buhari, say, are we likely to see a different approach in the fight against insecurity, especially kidnapping, which is a big issue now, sir? Make I explain that for Pidgin. In the talk, say, okay, oh, as insecurity don't they now reach this level, shall he get another plan when we go put to see, say, we do this insecurity matter, make it balance, because kidnapping don't reach the level where we say it don't hook us for throat. And President Muhammadu Buhari can't respond, say no. Say he don't see the Inspector General of Police and say the way when they look up, saying they lose weight. So he thinks saying they work hard. If we go explain that one, he means say, from the way when he takes the IGP, maybe he never they sleep well because of the matter when concerned. Say, okay, this is security, we must deal with them. And then they walk, so they take on the show, saying don't they lose weight. Once again, make we play that video. As I don't explain now, make we just play that video so that you go just use your ear now. Hear the question, hear the answer before I come meet our Ogbonge visitor inside studio. Make we watch him again. Now, when I don't hear him again. And the reason why I say make we play Anana so that I don't go talk anything about him, I go just go meet our Ogbonge visitor as him take him go answer this question. Now, from Katsina to Sokoto to Zamfara, even yesterday, permanent secretary inside Taraba, these kidnappers, bad guys, they moved the woman. We've been coming here talk about how inside the Daura, where President Muhammadu Buhari come from, he get a traditional ruler, senior man. When these kidnappers too, they also move. I want to ask, from the question when they ask Oga Presido and the answer when he give, what do you think of this matter?
He no been get any answer for that question.
So that answer not follow the question?
The answer not follow the question.
Why you talk so?
Apparently, the way where I see him, he no understand the question. Or maybe he no prepare an answer to, like, person will understand the question. I'm going to put them this way. They ask him, the premise of the question being, say, security problem, don't they? Kidnapping now, our default problem, as it be so. And we don't get some approaches where we use tackle when Easterners been get issues, when even Lagos and different other parts of the country been get these insecurity challenges, even for North, they been get an approach where they use manage the problem. Now, we don't see, say, this insecurity don't move towards the center of the North. Like you mentioned, Katsina, Taraba, look at the other one, this other place where they farm. Almost everybody in a farmer. I mean, for farmers to run away from their farmland because people they come kill them, they absolutely absurd. In fact, again, what I read, they tell them, say, no, men leave their guns on a security operatives, they come protect them. Before you know, the people who carry guns come, and people who actually won't come kill them, won't come destroy them. And all these things, they happen under our president's watch. Unfortunately, maybe he just they come back from where he go. So maybe he don't even get any brief of what thing they go on directly from the people where they hear from. And they can't throw this question at him. We been expect saying go get real answer. We go allay our fears. Say, no, we're on top of the problem. We've seen the situation. And now I'm back. There will be a change. And just throw the thing to the IG. IG know they're in charge of the army. IG know they're in charge of some security like DSS and others. Because kidnapping don't enter this matter. Now say intelligence don't enter this thing. For some states, we say they've been done, they collect ransom. and go to school, kidnap some children. They say make the owners of the kids pay 15 million, 2 million, 3 million. So, you know, they say that they do this out of bias, out of, you know, out of animus. It should say they don't turn them to profit-making venture.
So, now business.
Now business.
For these bad people, where they do this thing.
Purely business.
Make motivated. I ask quick. What of if to say we look this matter, can't say, maybe, for example, if we read newspapers, we go hear this, that. For example, this now Vanguard newspaper. And the headline now, how we survived bandits' attacks. They can't put Katsina Zamfara victims. The guy waiting there, they call Rider for news.
Yes.
They say bandits killed all men, set our villages ablaze.
Yes.
15 soldiers killed, 19 wounded in Boronu. We lost 5 men, killed scores of terrorists, military, and I talk this one. Army bans use of motorcycles in Kano, Zamfara, Sokoto, Kebbi, Katsina, Kaduna, Niger. They can also end with security stakeholders, task government on urgent intervention.
Yes.
Now, if we check all these states, when I call where I'm saying maybe we'll something they use Okada, it don't cut across several states inside the border of Nigeria. I mean, they say, our army people, they do their best to look into the situation. But it be like, say, with what would they see? This die. For this particular one, the story when Oga Presido they hear, maybe he not rhyme with this particular one.
He not rhyme.
Because if he asks his service chiefs then, for example, say, how are we doing? If they explain another thing, give them. Now he be saying, now the one when they explain, give them, now he go take. How we go get situation where we say, the real matter when they happen, President Muhammadu Buhari go fit here. Because the president and commander-in-chief of the armed forces.
We know, say, President Buhari, they read newspaper.
Okay.
We don't see pictures where in whole paper for hand.
Okay.
Like that, than when we win election, we see different pictures will come out.
True.
So even if in the year from service chiefs, if they read paper, just the same way you read this one, now so I read them, now so in two, they read them. Now, if you tell me, say, they don't give them paper today or yesterday, we feel understand. But then, I mean, they very absurd to say, president, no read paper. Besides waiting the air from service, how we won't take no say the service chief they tell the truth. Make I give you an example. Vanguard and talk say people will be victims of the crime. Talk say 15 soldiers, 9 and kill. Army saying a lie. Now only 5.
Now only five
people will lose. Then talk say these people now ISIS, in fact, IS, this Islamic State being claim responsibility. Say, no, now we do this thing for Boronu. Army say no. Bandits.
Or unknown government.
You know,
unknown assailants.
They just, you know, reduce the intensity of the matter. For reasons known to them. They say, these now people will carry guns and real weapons. They attack people. I mean, say, no, now people will drive motorcycle, now will they chase after. You know, show coordination in waiting that they do. And these now things where people don't sit down, document, journalists don't sit down, write. They could not verify the facts where they present. And so, our president, no fit deny, say, he no know some of these things. Now why I talk, say, he no prepare for the answer we ain't give. And he no think I'm out very carefully. So the best thing for say, if I take the bull by the horn, say, Oga, we are on top of the solution, I'm back. And now that I'm back, the game will change. We'll take the war back to them. But for this way they talk, we need new approach.
Look, we even, talking about new approach now, he not go do to just talk, say, I am on top of the situation, because we don't, no situation for this country. Where we know they're on top.
Yes.
But they be like say the results, we know they see them.
Yeah.
For health sector, we are on top. for power, we are on top.
Yes.
For security, we are on top. Everything, we are on top. But the job like say somehow, in the end, when we see output, you know, they be like that.
Yeah.
And as somebody when we say you know, issues of politics and social commentary, you they think I'm well and you they get idea. If we won't find lasting solution to this problem, it's possible, say, we go find lasting solution. I mean, I'm fasting and prayer. What do we go do to find a solution to this problem?
Like you talk, make we this serious. Make we look the matter as it be. We no fit they dwell on different set of facts to solve a particular problem. No, we no go work. This one, they deny, say, see what thing happen. This one, they talk, say, IG don't lose weight. How IG won't, if the guy is sick, I won't take no. Like you talk, health sector no work. The health sector don't already affect IG. I won't take no. So we got to be serious about the problem. We got to look at them rationally and then say, okay, this is not the direction where we won't go. Two, we need real leadership. President Buhari, if he don't talk with how he go, say, make this thing go. The people where he go execute them, he say, I beg, the old man don't tire, I beg, make we just sit down, nothing they happen. See all the states where they involved. I mean, all these states, Then most of them been vote for President Buhari.
If we go by the numbers.
If we go by the numbers, now them put them in. So now their reward for voting in be this. No, come on, we got to be serious with ourselves. You know? So if we get serious with the problem, come decide to work with one set of facts. There are armed bandits, one. There are terrorists that have moved inland Nigeria, two. And number three, there are people that have decided to use to make money out of these things. Then we're going to say, okay, make we begin, they know what to do. We need to upgrade our intelligence. The people where they work as intelligence services, this one, the other one, they need to come to serious. Make them come tell us the truth. Are they for us? Are they against us? They don't go just they do anyhow. Expect, say, result could just fall in like that. So like I say, make we serious with the problem. Number two, make we work with the same set of facts. Number three, make we get real leadership. So this way, in charge of these things ought to go. And I suspect, say, now waiting president they look into. So these people are not serious. Make them command them. They know. Make them bring people. We go take this bull by the horn. So see what in Sultan talk. Listen, Sultan. He said, I speak truth to power. All these kidnapping things where they suffer. Where Satan has they suffer now. We don't reach us for naught. Now we guys they serious about that. All the service chiefs, now not on us. We know we say one Satan has they sabotage the government. So now our problem. Make we face them. Make we face up to the problem. Face them squarely.
Okay. Face the problem. Face them squarely and find lasting solution. To Ram, the person when join voice, like you talk, the Emir of Kano, he talk amo, say this one not, he don't, if we look the problem now, he don't come house now.
Yes.
If to say then say, okay, now only these people they there, it go be like say they no one walk. But if the thing they affect us and our people, why he be say, we not see result. Talking about the health sector, you get story when they inside Daily Trust, they do better work on top of Ram. And they talk say, patients, when they go our teaching hospitals, then they talk, say, the kind condition when those hospitals, they're very poor. If we look at level of hospitals for Nigeria, we get primary health care.
Yes.
The one where we say, all these small, like you want.
Immunization.
Yeah, you won't carry, like you carry your, you all just won't carry your motor, go car wash. Then we get the secondary, where we say, okay, you don't need. Then we get the teaching hospitals, where the future of those when go stand and mind the gap for the healthcare. Nadia then go firsthand, see as the thing they be and learn them. And Nadia be say, the kind of work when plenty of them they do there. Now they enter newspaper, enter breaking news.
Yes.
Say, see what men and women then do. But our patients, then when they go to this hospital, plenty of them don't come and they talk, say, some of this hospital, if you go with, say, Belen, they paying you, by the time when you come back, hand and leg, if you don't join the belly when they pay you. They say some kind of bad smell when they come out from this hospital. Some kind of suck away when we say then they open. Some kind of gutter when just dead there. Now something when we say they're very, very bad. Our people when they for us now, if you now see what's in there on top of our screen. This thing when they are our screen now, in our infographics. Now breakdown of the way when we say the matter don't day inside of Obodo, Nigeria. And I go just want me to put an eye on top of that thing. Make I read out. Now I'm gonna look some of the major challenges when they face for our teaching hospitals. Some of the issues, the challenges when they face for teaching hospitals. If we now see the first one when they up, they talk say obsolete equipment and malfunctioning machines. Meaning say the equipment when they use for there, some of them are old school and some they know they work. Make we now come down, look at the second one. They say rising cost of services. Patients pay as high as 60,000 naira monthly for dialysis. Dialysis na treatment where we say then they use for one sickness. When plenty of us go, they tell ourselves, say, it's not my portion, it's not my portion. But remember, say, human being, no, they use battery, no, they use charger. If you kidney issue come, you must treat them 60,000 monthly for dialysis. Minimum wage itself, now 30,000 at the end of the month. Make una come down and say, lack of steady power supply and high cost of diesel for generator. Inside hospital, light, no day, oh, light. We don't know whether a torchlight, nine doctor go hold. They use, they do operation. And they say, diesel, the price don't go up. Make una come for down. They say, non-availability of some test services within the hospital. They say, patients have to go outside and pay outrageous amounts for tests. Some of the places where we say they're supposed to test you. Some of the places where we say they go test you to say, okay, oh, now this sickness, they want you this person, oh. They say the thing, no day, he not dead yet. And sometimes the patients, them go outside. They'll tell you, say, go do this test outside. We know they do am here. You can't go outside. You can't hear money when we say, it could even be like seven, you just carry your sickness, they go house. When I see this four matter when we say, I just mentioned, equipment, when then they use, some na old school, some no they at all. Money when people they pay, dialysis, they say reach 60,000. They also talk about light, power, steady power for inside hospital, where sick people, they, whether they do operation or for hospital. And they also talk about test. We not fit do this test here. Go outside, go do test. Who know whether the people, when they tell you, when you go outside, go do test, then they work with those, when get that place, so they do test. Okay, you fit go do test outside, and for hospital, they not fit do test there. Make we they think now, our own hospital, we not fit do test. Outside, where we go pay plenty money, they fit do test there. What do those ones they do, when our hospital not fit do? When I see this for, make we not go back, make we show now that graphics, I must talk on this problem here today. I tell us this as we go talk. Make we just watch on our screen now. Put up a hair. Make I go back to up now. The one went there by the right. I hope everybody they watch now. Then talk say, poor funding and revenue. We don't have enough or have not received commensurate funding. And the person went on this one at the CMD of UUTH. UUTH, University of Uyo Teaching Hospital. He said they don't get plenty money, or they know they receive enough. And every year, budget, health. We get health minister for inside this country. And yet, they know they receive enough. But we come down, that one won't be like a bed. They say inadequate bed space. Patients were seen with their beddings and mats under trees in AKTH. Hey. To see space to sleep on top of bed for hospital, it don't turn to say you must know person, oh. They say for AKTH, they see people, they sleep under tree. Person went sick, he bring his own bed from house. Come, they sleep under tree. Under tree for hospital. Hey, make we not see the third one, where it be like say plenty people gather. They say number of doctors far below World Health Organization benchmark of one doctor to 250 patients. When are they here? World Health Organization, join body. When we say they took her inside everything, when they concern health, they say at least, for country to fit beat their chest, get pride, say then they work for healthcare. One doctor supposed there for 250 people. For Nigeria, the number are like 1 to 6,000. Oh, if we go by say according to Nigerian Medical Association, they say that 72,000 registered doctors that we get, and half of that number, if you, they don't come out inside Obodo Nigeria. Make I give you the last one today. We go talk. But when I see that last one, we'll be like say it be like snake. Nothing won't bend, but now human being when they talk. They say bad odor overwhelms some sections of the hospital in UATH. Bad odor, hospital, odor, bad smell. When not be where then they throw away their tea. Hospital, bad odor, it full everywhere. Then they call the names of this hospital. Now we can go to the affected hospitals. If we not see that graphic so we put for television, we now go see something will be like a map of Nigeria. For inside that map of Nigeria, we now see color. Now those color. Now the places where we say problem day. Make we go that grab more and see. So that if we talk all this problem, they mention all these places, everybody go begin, they know, and we'll go they identify. When I don't see them, now hospital then draw for them. All those color. Now the places where we say issue day. Now this is now the affected states. Now the first one, we get UDUTH, Sokoto. That one now the Usman Danfodio Teaching Hospital inside the Sokoto state. We can't get AKTH. That one, therefore, inside Kano. We also get, I know, now this one I will call last. We get JUTH, that one now for inside the Jos. We get UMTH, that one now for inside the Maiduguri. We get FMC for Yola. We get UUTH for Uyo. And the last one, oh, Nigerians, oh, shame, no, they are our face, oh. UATH, Abuja. The Federal Capital Territory of Nigeria, where we get our capital, where senators, then they go do meeting, where House of Reps, they go do meeting, the state where we say President Muhammadu Buhari, they live, then to follow for affected places. What did they worry us for inside this country? And we get health minister, with the budget money, will they do this, will they do that? Now you go answer this question, because if the woman that they talk self, you go see, say, I don't they sweat.
I mean, what you go talk again? Kudos to the guys who do this report. Mm. Those they've been do a thorough job. I look the article and say, wow. Mm. We got problem for this country. Mm-hmm. And this now the states where they fit cover. They get one of them, that one where they acquire doctor, I mean, whether Basi or something like that. Been defend himself, say injuries come and other things, say no be like this the day before, say they no fit buy Dizu, plenty talk. I say, what?
They no fit buy Dizu.
You know, say even if the whether even the gens they walk, they don't know whether the gens they walk. Plenty stories where they talk. I mean, then talk this thing finish. I look at ourselves and say, no. We no fit day like this. Like you talk, Abuja own nine bad pass. This not the seat of power. Obviously, the Minister of Health know they go these teaching hospitals. The worst part, they say, these are teaching hospitals. These are places where they produce the future doctors of this country. Now they say, at least, worst case scenario, they supposed to get one doctor to one patient for these teaching hospitals because almost everybody now a doctor. Almost everybody now a healthcare professional. This is now where they learn. Now, for those places now to come be the rot of the health sector in this country, of hospitals in this country, well, then we get problem with that. How you feel, say, they go come out, come perform in other hospitals? Unfortunately, sorry to say it, most private hospitals now don't do better than the public hospitals. Most. And but when you go there, they go use money, won't cut your head, come out, finish. They get one teaching hospital, I don't want to mention the name. Where they talk, say, now you go use your leg, enter the hospital. Now your dead body go come out. Can you imagine? And like you talk, if a person go get stomach ache, but then go enter leg, don't join, hand, don't join, plenty of that things. No be lie. Some people, they die for hospital because of the conditions of the hospital than waiting carry them come. Now, for teaching hospitals to come be like the depth of the sewer, like the bottom pit of the garbage, 9 days more painful. So I go leave my house, leave my bed, carry mattress, carry mat, come to sleep for outside for hospital. And yet, I never see doctor. If you read the articles, they talk, say, this people, they still stand in line when they see doctor. Can you imagine how far we don't go in this country? Our healthcare need healthcare. Now, you talk that in one time. Say, our healthcare need healthcare. And not true.
Okay. We don't need to talk too much for this particular one because, like you talk, these people, for Daily Trust, they do plenty work.
No, they do thorough job.
They don't tell us the problems.
Yes.
And it go good. If we want to say we're serious, make we open the books.
Exactly.
All the money where we don't put every year, make we know where the money they go. Make we know who spend them. Make we know what they spend them on top. See, accountability. Once you dey inside government, once you enter inside government, everything will concern the work when they do. Now public business.
Yes.
And if you fail in your responsibility, you should be held accountable and liable.
Yes.
If we want to show the government they're serious, all these kinds of issues when they affect the ordinary Nigerian people, now we suppose they address. Make we enter on that one when they affect ordinary Nigerian people. I go like ask you, and I go like make you follow me. A person when they find better health, he go hospital, have you no go hospital?
Suppose go hospital.
Very true. Person when they find salvation, he won't go heaven. You go church or you go mosque. You know, you go. Person when they find knowledge, you go library. I mean, you know, go library.
You go library.
Thank you very much. But according to Professor Biodun Ogunyemi, the Oga Patapata of ASU, Joint Body Academic Staff Union of Universities, he don't come out to talk, say, our library for public universities. Say, when we just go there, they sell agege bread. Because if you go there, if you enter there, if you enter there, no, you say A is for apple. By the time when you come back, if you even know, if you come to the beginning, they say A is for Enugu. Because he said the books when they're there. Some of these books, now books when we say, they talk about Amadu Bello University. They say the library, the books when they're there. Make I just carry the quotes, make you know, be like, say, Nami Tokamo, I will carry the exact quotes when they're for here. Okay, Abubakar Tafawa Balewa, yes, University. They say the library, some of the books when they're there, they don't reach 30 years old.
Yes.
Not be bad thing, say book, now 30 years old.
No.
Now good, because once anything where you read, you go always know. But the university librarian, Dr. Musa Bello, say the university gets over 80,000 books for a library. And it was many of them. They don't be old school.
Yes.
And the last time when they buy plenty of those books, now 1981, if we do plus or minus, 1991, 10 years.
Yes.
2001, 20 years. 2011, 30 years. If you call out 2011, call it 2019, we know how many years the books, the last time when they buy books, plenty of those books for inside that particular place. Make we move for make we enter inside the Unilag. The person when the Unilag talk say they get over 509,719 volumes of books, yeah. And 708,319 print journal titles inside the university. It's he not bad like that if you get old books, but it go good make we understand say as things they change for this life and as people they grow, you go need new things. The only thing talking based on say we go need new, but it's not bad make we get old one. See the one where we say it cause problem for me. University of Nigeria. Now there I go. So this one they pay me well. Final year student of accountancy, Ekene Aneke. He said when he been they go to the library, he know they find the kind of books when we say he want. He's saying they do in research, oh,
as per final
and the library supposed to be where you go get this information. Mm-hmm. He saying you know they see. He also talks about the e-library when they say they get, since he come to school, he never fit access the e-library. And some of the students talk say for 4 years when they don't do that school, they never enter the library. Say he just be like say he just go somewhere, go sit down. Maybe people go sit down for his house or sit down for hostel, reading book. I won't ask. The quality of education, the standard of education for inside the world of Nigeria, make we not like give ourselves. If we talk about structure, we know say we dey far behind. Looking at Nigeria's population and the available resources when they. But if we want to salvage this situation, that is to save this situation, not in say for Nigeria today, going by the last number when they put out, those when we say them be 0 to 14 years, whenever even start life, there'll be around 88 million of our population. And now these people will grow, enter inside our university,
yes.
Go read the book, to come back, to contribute to the development of our society. Where exactly we go start from?
I mean, where we want to start? Education is key.
Mm-hmm.
See, this is where you don't lay out. I mean, if person really look at them, they're more frightening than you, they actually talk at UI,
say,
you know, even enter UI.
Meaning anything, they fear, the team must fear person.
No, if they fear person, where? Just imagine like that school where you call now. Like, for 38 years, they don't get new books. Now if you say person will go to that school, come out, in knowledge, they 38 years old. In fact, the knowledge senior arm. So how that person won't take profile solutions to Nigerian problems?
How students when they study accounting go talk saying won't do research? In go library, he not see what they related to what they do today.
Simple. Because the books no they there. The e-library where they say tech fund, you know tech fund. Tech fund. Been award a lot of contracts. Asu don't shout. See, kudos to Asu for bringing these things to light. Asu don't shout. Third phone say, okay, oh yeah, make we award library this, library upgrade, buying of books, building of library structure, plenty projects where they don't do. And all of a sudden, the outcome of these things cannot be visible.
No, Verso. This thing not show, say, we as Nigerians, self. Forget government. Government get problem. We as Nigerians, we wicked. Because as a contractor, they give you contracts. You collect money to deliver. The money, meaning say, somebody think come now, yes. Give the money.
Yes.
You collect the money.
Yes.
But you not deliver the thing where you supposed to deliver. We fish out government. But we as Nigerians, we not wicked like this.
No, first of all, that's wickedness on your part.
Thank
but
you
second,
very much.
What is the standard of delivery? You feel say some of these new projects where they award, they don't go buy old books, put. I mean, really, why you they shout say they don't deliver? Some of them they tell me they build library, they build the structure, they don't tell them when they furnish them. Some of them they say buy books. They say books, Abi, we go buy puts. They go buy old. After all, the older the book, the cheaper it is in the market.
So the person when they even they give money self must hold koboko. As if they give you money,
if they check
to see
whether you buy what they tell you make you buy.
Wisdom.
UI, I will not go UI. UI has 2.2 million. Books, materials,
combined. University of Ibadan.
What thing happened? At the end of the day, they are still up to the librarian. They try defend. Blessing a woman. She try cover up the thing. They defend the thing. Say, madam, what are you telling us? These things, students don't feel use and graduate. Okay, students don't use and graduate. Now, medical students, they come out, they mess up for their teaching hospital. Not be the same school. Not be the same. Is this a problem there? Our universities and institutions of higher learning. Real problem. The government need to really look into this problem because. We cannot be producing with a shot half-baked. At the end of the day, people will come out. You go UNN. You know the day when they build UNN library? At least the one with the Nsukka. You see the magnificent structure
we,
with them.
We've been the claim saying are the biggest
for West Africa.
For West Africa. The
biggest in what? In structure.
So we don't now, get big building.
We don't get big building, fine, pictures full everywhere. They don't feel use them. When you do school, you go to the library. Reading room where they, no be reading room, that reading room where light, you know, the day where everybody they sweat, carry candle, come school. That time, then they. Yeah. You did school when they move, enter the new library. If you go there, and you're going to say, see. Okay, this is where they claim old books, old books. Okay, it's good to have old books. You know, fit even reference the old books. You know, fit access them, like then catalog them correctly, make you fit even reference them. Let's say you be one even user. You get some books where it be, you know,
evergreen, they must always be now.
How you want to even access those books? When transcript, they don't even feel fine for you. You can't be books.
Like transcript, though.
We have, see, we get big problem for this country. And until, like you say, accountability can't be the watchword of government and their contracts and their institutions together, then we know they're serious.
We go open our phone lines, or our people more than no verse. More just knock the final story. Talking about accountability now. Serap, they do plenty work.
Yes.
Me and Unkubi, the way what would they call Serap, on top of this show. One day, the yoga of Serap, I promise you now, no bet, I go carry and come here, make him sit down. And the day when I go sit down there, I go tell him, say, Oga, nobody love una reach us. Because Serap, then they do plenty work as they consign to hold government accountable. Yeah. Now, they don't come with the result, what we don't see. Yeah. But now, the next step from here, that will be the result. Because according to information now, Serap, for February, they've been carry the Minister of Power, Works and Housing, go court.
Yes.
Say, based on freedom of information, we ask you to give us information. You can't do like this. Now, in don't talk, say, in don't give them the information. First, before we even talk about this information, when we say, Oga Fashola, don't carry, give Serap people. Make we look the problem of, say, we go give contractor work.
Yes.
Contractor go collect money. The fact say you carry money come, give them, meaning say you understand, say this is a problem, okay, make una take money. We can't give contractor money. For example, the person when the company when we say their name for this particular one, the thing when they're supposed to deliver, it's supposed to be 19. But from 2014, when they collect money 5 years ago, they just do with wahala, with shout, do 13, can't leave her like that. I beg. Shout out say they don't give them the money complete. And at the money when they give them for, now they do. The price when they sell the thing, or the cost when it for cost them for 2014, it don't come different now. We need to give them balance. I don't understand.
Now, the problem of contracting in Nigeria, they big. Make I tell you, because I get insider information into that sector. Contracting in Nigeria has a long way to go. This is what you talk now one very good example. Out of 19 equipments we supposed to supply, you supply only 13. Then pay them out of 87, about 87 million we supposed to pay, where they suppose the contract supposed to be. They give them like
79 million.
That's about 90% of the money so far to date. And then he supplied about, I think, 65% of the number of equipment we supposed to supply. And 2014, well, in 2019, that's 5 years. How long was the contract supposed to be?
Thank you very much. What will be the duration?
The contract duration. Because, make I tell you something, the time value of money, they matter in every contract. If now 6 months, you know, deliver them in 6 months, then...
Maybe say the money will shoot up.
Exactly, the money will shoot up. Or the equipment where they go buy, the cost will go up. A lot of things go change. 2014 to 2019, what will they talk? This is a different government entirely from the government where I award the contract.
No, verse. We get Fabulous on top of our telephone line from Bayelsa. Fabulous, welcome to our city hall.
Yeah, thank you, Chokwude, and Mazi, I don't know his name.
Engineer Ikechukwu.
Engineer Ikechukwu. Good evening, sir.
Good evening, thank you.
Hello?
Would they hear your guy Fabulous, they talk?
Okay, you are talking about insecurity in Nigeria. My brother, you sure say Nigeria will figure security?
Why not?
I don't think so, because where they don't pack all the security and police, army, give to themselves, how Nigeria will take security again now? Okay, imagine, white man will come to Nigeria, they carry all our security, give the man. He go they follow and they walk about, but we go their country, they may go even see our face. So how Nigeria will get security now? Okay, imagine Bayelsa State. Young boys, they shoot guys anyhow, anyhow. They snatch people back anyhow. Because of war, there is no life. If you stand for road, if you want to enter into KK or anything, they will come and snatch your bag or do one or two things to you. Why? No life. Life is part of the security. But in Nigeria, if you are talking about security, you are talking nonsense.
Oga Fabulous, thank you very much for this your important contribution. Make we enter inside Nasarawa from Bayelsa. Collect this call from Emmanuel. Oga Emmanuel, welcome to our city hall. Oga Emmanuel, you there, there? I beg if you get a chance, call us back when you make your contribution and stay concerned this subject. And you've been there talk about, you know, collecting
contracting,
money.
Yeah, contracting Nigeria. So, you see, when you bring a company in the court of public opinion, you guys also give the company some leverage or leeway to defend themselves. But in this case, an example of something where they supposed do, where they supposed finish, where they don't finish. So apparently they've not finished it. There fit be blames fit day on every side of every stakeholder on this thing. You go into government, you by that way you go collect contract, B number one go dead here. Now government itself now ain't get B number one in the sense that they go a lot of things, monitoring and evaluation, when they go do, the money goes to them. And then go they come, they push you up and down for their. See, make we no hide mouth, talk these things. It they happen. We know, say it they happen. And it is timing, it kind of like, it they arm twist the contractor from doing the work where they supposed to do. And then at the end of the day, what do you expect? The contractor too go make money. See, no contractor won't do business just for without profit. Everybody won't make money, but they won't also make money by delivering the job.
We get another person on top of our telephone line. Good evening and welcome to our city hall, Oga Samuel. Oga Samuel, you there? Oga Samuel, you there? Reduce the volume of your television. I beg, if you want call us, just reduce the volume of your television. Make we hear and wait till you get to talk on top of this particular matter. So, now, the truth be say, contractor won't make money, but contractor will like do the work so that you will look and say, okay, in case another one day tomorrow, because he do this one well, then we'll go call and make him do another one. Okay, but moving on from here now, as we get a minister, we don't identify company now. Say, okay, Una, we give Una money, Una no do the contract. What is supposed to be the next step?
In every contract, they get ways of handling the default of the contract. The contract itself goes state and clearly. If you default, see what thing will happen to you. If you don't default, whoever out of the stakeholders will default their own part of the contract, see the punishment or see what thing they go do to remedy the problem. First of all, they just evaluate these things very clearly. I know, say, Nigeria, we they good at setting up committees to evaluate failed projects and all these type of things. We need to go back and solve the problem from the beginning. When you want award the contract, this person, when you say, go give the contract, in Sabiduam,
he get
track record of delivering the contract.
Oguche, they qualified to talk for on top of this show. Welcome to our city hall.
Yes, hello.
We did fine, though.
Yeah, I greet you for the topic I made. Very, very interesting.
They talk, would they hear you?
Yes, I said, good evening. I thank you for the program.
Thank you very much.
There's one thing you talk about, the hospitals, our hospitals. The hospitals, they are very bad. The Minister of Health is saying that people should travel out, that we have a lot of doctors.
Okay, Buche, we hear you. Reduce the volume of your television. Freeman, welcome to Asri Hot. Freeman, you there? Oga Freeman from Abuja. I beg if you get a chance, we don't lock our telephone line as a day like this. We don't leave the place where we say, we'll just finish the talk, carry waka come off our house. Now you talk, say, the competence and qualification of the company.
Of the supposed contractors.
Very
get
important.
Track record. Government know them. See, government get ways of ranking contractors based on competence, based on the projects executed, success of those projects, where they failed, where they this, where they that. We need to go back, go see, say, government, they actually implement these things. Government get ministries and get agencies where they follow up each of their projects. Mm-hmm. We need to check those people where they implement, because how you go pay somebody 90% of the money and he just delivers 65% of the work? 90% is as good as done. What do you remain are your retention, retention and defect liability period. Then remain. So at 90%, it's as good as the work has been completed.
Mm-hmm.
So somebody approve, make them pay some of these contractors up to 90% of their money. Mm-hmm. Now, where of that fashion that they shout.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to solve these problems on both sides. Select competent contractors and make sure that the agency of government that is supervising these contractors are doing their job without, you know, without fear or favor. Because some of them, when they just, when contractor just say, Oga, Ramadan Kareem, they say, yes, 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 my friend, keep the, Oga, we just say, make we use this one, do Ramadan for you.
Hmm.
They say, oh, okay, yes, yes, fine. Where that your certificate, they come, no worry, I go down. I don't already approve, I'm going to say, we day fasting, I know we'll come site this period. All those things, how, I mean, why should it be? We need to go back, go make sure, say, people, they do their job in season, like Bible go talk, and out of season. And we need to make sure, say, the contractors who we hire, they're competent. Maybe everybody will just carry portfolio, go CAC, package company together, don't turn contractor. No. Then get the requisite competence to deliver the projects when they want, when they don't award, give them.
Mm.
These are questions we need to ask.
Very important questions, so we need to ask. Our people, when they for us, they say, Nigeria and our country, you know, go spoil. Everything we do to you, see, say, we make our country better, make we do it. And when I go remember, say, for one of the studies, when we talk about contractors, when we collect contracts, collect money, but they don't go do the work. We've been talk, say, okay, keep government for one side. Make we look ourselves for mirror and tell ourselves the truth. People, when they're government, they don't come from Malaysia. They don't come from Togo. They be Nigerians. And people, when we say they live inside Obodo, Nigeria, we're supposed to support government. And also do say, from their immediate community, everything better. Now, Nigerian people, we must work hard. If we not play our own role, problem go there. And every time we'll continue to shout and we'll continue to cry. So, as patriotic and law-abiding citizens, people won't get love for this country and we won't work, make this country better. We must play our own part. And most importantly, because I know people when the government go to talk, say, yes, tell them. Make I also tell you now, they're very, very important. See, once you enter inside government, not be anybody business, whether you be better papa, better mama, better wife, better husband, better uncle, you dey spend money for your village people, you dey do this, no. You get core mandate. What will be your mandate? Your mandate now to deliver on the promises and the responsibility when they attach to your office.
Yes.
If you not do, I know my pan go do. You not do that position, now you do that position. If you be president and commander-in-chief of the armed forces, if you be governor, if you be senator, if you be a speaker, if you be this, if you be that, do your work well and do the thing. Make this our country better. Our people, until we come back again tomorrow with plenty story we concern our great country, Nigeria, we'll continue to talk the matter, we'll continue to discuss solution, and Nigeria go better. Engineer, thank you very much. Say,
thank
come
you,
we appreciate it. Una, bye-bye. To enjoy more of this, our Ogbonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.